And we all have a choice: make a living or design a life.
Welcome to the fourth episode of Self-Revolution, the Strength Series. Now, I'm not going to do any sort of intro or recap for this particular video, so if you haven't yet, please check out my other videos in the series, and I'll post the links to that somewhere around here. But before we get started, I just wanted to make a huge shout out to you guys. Really, really big thank you for all your subscriptions, your likes, your comments on my videos. I really, really appreciate you guys' support, and like I said, I want to grow this channel as much as I can and help out as many people as I can, so your subscriptions and likes and comments are really helping, and I love reading your comments and engaging with you guys and having conversations with you, so keep that up, keep doing what you're doing, and a big thanks. So let's get started. Welcome to Seattle, where it arbitrarily starts pouring just in the middle of the day, and there are basically monsoons every few days at completely random times, even though it was totally sunny and beautiful out earlier. Ah! That's awesome. That was lightning. Of course, I'm trying to cook. I hope there's no storm or anything that prevents me from actually finishing my meal prep for the week. Last week we had 2 fire alarms on Sunday when I was trying to get stuff done. And that's not fun for productivity. But I'm sitting in the dark right now because my light went out in my room. Just in my room, not actually the rest of my floor, because I was hecka multitasking. I was trying to cook mac and cheese. It was almost ready to be poured in. Oh, I'm making 2 boxes because I live on the edge. And I was also trying to microwave my food. This is what happens when food rules your life. So remember yesterday when I was talking about the torrential downpours in Seattle and how the weather is completely random and kind of frightening at times? This is literally a day apart. This is the view I have from my room. Just totally peaceful, amazing, blue skies. You can't really see Rainier from the background, but still, kind of ridiculous. So that is Seattle in November, and apparently it's supposed to get below 40 degrees this week, so I think it's really funny. I've been watching Christian and Nikki's videos, and they're saying how they're so excited to be able to wear hoodies and stuff to the gym, and I'm like, I've been wearing like a jacket and a coat to the gym for the last like 2.5 months or so. But and since we're here, I wanted to quickly share with you my freezer, because I live on YouTube, you guys, it's pretty bad. But here's my freezer. I got it. It's not just a fridge. I have a fridge and a freezer. So this is just a giant freezer. I was really excited because Maxx Chewning posted on his video, and this is literally exactly what he ate. And I've got slow churned cookies and cream ice cream and slow churned mint cookie crunch ice cream in my freezer. And yeah, I have a lot of ice cream in my fridge. So first of all, that was a quick shout out to Maxx Chewning, because we are totally twinning right now, which is awesome. But secondly, I'm gonna have to say, if you're in college and if you just have one of those crappy little fridges with a tiny little mini freezer in them, definitely invest in one of these guys. I got mine out on walmart.com, I think, for like $140. You guys, I can have ice cream and frozen meats. It's really nice because I don't have to, if I ever want to cook with like ground turkey or something, I can just bulk buy it and keep it in my freezer and then pull it out whenever. If you want to have things like frozen foods or even frozen vegetables or meats or the more important things in life, like slow-churned ice cream. It is Tuesday, November 11th, and I'm just having lunch. We don't have school today because it's Veterans Day. So thank you to all the veterans. Kraft mac and cheese with some extra lean ground turkey meatloaf and some boiled carrots. It's actually a pretty low-fat meal right now, because this is a recipe that has extra lean ground turkey. They're usually a little more attractive, but extra lean ground turkey is typically white, so it doesn't get that brown color like beef does. So that's a modification of Jamie Eason's monster meatloaf. Gonna enjoy that with some Diet Coke from a fancy cup. Hey guys, so here's some footage from Tuesday, the 11th of November. This was a very heavy leg day for me. It was beautiful in Seattle. Unfortunately, it was also really, really windy, so I
the sound in this was absolutely terrible, so I'm doing a voiceover. I just wanted to show how gorgeous it is in Seattle right now. All the leaves are falling, the colors are beautiful, the sun's out. However, when it's a sunny in Seattle, it's also really, really cold because there's no cloud coverage. It's really, really freezing in the dorms. They had just turned the heater on there. I actually had to wear leg warmers a couple times to the gym this week. So I was just saying that I'm hoping that it's not too cold to actually do legs today. And so before I start talking about this footage, I wanted to share a story with you. A couple months ago, I was training legs and a woman in the gym walked up to me and she said, "Hey, your squats look so great. Would you mind taking a look at mine and telling me what to do?" And she started doing squats in front of me and asking me, you know, "Am I doing this round or is it this? Just tell me what to do." And I started telling her, well, you know, like I tell you guys, squats are not a natural movement. We end up sitting at work, at school all day and in these weird unnatural positions. And you have to teach your body how to squat. It's really not a natural movement. And all she wanted was, you know, that quick fix. Like, how do you, just tell me what to do here. And yeah, sure, everybody can tell you, you know, your hips need to go past your knees, your weight needs to be on your heels, you need to keep your chest up, you need to keep your shoulder over your heels, all these things. But at the end of the day, it's not a quick fix. And I see a lot of people trying to throw around a lot of weight without actually having that foundation yet. Take the time you need to figure out your squats. I've been lifting for 30 years. My squats still aren't perfect, but they're significantly better than they were last year. And that's because I spent literally the entire summer doing box squats with a 45-pound bar on a bench, sitting on it, and then getting back up. And that's how I figured out how to use, you know, my hip flexors and learned about these different parts of the body. I'm gonna link something below that was really helpful for me. Brett Contreras has a lot of great articles. But you guys, figure out how to use those muscles first and realize that even as you get better with your squats or whatever lift that may be, you still need to be continuing to make progress and to continuing to check in with yourself. You know, actually videotaping these, my training has really helped me because it helps me look at myself and then look at my form and see how I've improved. And like right now, I didn't even realize how much my shoulders were coming over my feet until I started watching this. So definitely record yourself. Keep posted about your own progress. Here, I think something that was really motivating for me, actually, this was definitely a really good leg day for me. I've never had that much range. I've never felt so strong. I've never felt like I'm actually pushing through my heels until the last few months. And I really think that all adds up to the fact that I took the time to learn and figure out which muscles you need to use. You know, what is this supposed to feel like? And it's definitely, it feels much more stable now. It hurts a lot less. It doesn't really hurt at all, except, you know, the muscles that are supposed to be sore. And it makes me feel a lot better about them. And on that note, you guys, even when you feel comfortable with the movement, even if you feel like you've mastered something, don't stop learning, don't stop researching, don't stop growing. Like I said at the end of every video, keep researching different methods, keep researching the muscle groups, the different techniques, the different cues that you can use to improve and keep getting better, because you can always better your best. And this kind of segues into this really not so great deadlifts. I'm keeping my back safe and everything, so it's not a risk here, but I can definitely have better movement. You know, you can see I'm kind of, it's not very fluid here. There's definitely a breakup in between the different body movements, and it's just, it looks kind of uncomfortable, so I can definitely be a little more smooth with the transition over my knees and sink my butt down a little lower with that, and that is something I'm working on. Videotaping really helps. And it definitely helps with that instant feedback. And I wanted to show this clip, you guys, not because of the exercise, but because look at how many people are walking around. I have my camera set up here. It's kind of awkward and uncomfortable. It's in the middle of the gym. But sometimes, you know, you might be kind of worried about what people are thinking about you in the gym, but you do you. Everyone's in the gym, or they should be, to improve themselves and to become a better version of yourself. So never let the fact that the gym is busy or intimidating stop you from doing what you need to.
Hey guys, I just wanted to show you how cold it is right now in Seattle. It was really sunny today, as you guys saw earlier in that footage. Unfortunately, when it's really sunny and there's no cloud coverage, it's also freezing. So, I am currently wearing, this is my bodybuilding.com shirt, but you can't really see, a jacket, a sweatshirt, an actual shell, and then I'm wearing these boots, and I've got two pairs of socks on underneath. So it's really, really cold, and apparently the heat is on in our building, but it's still freezing. and leg day was kind of hard, but I thought it went really well. And I'm finally, you guys, I'm so happy because those drills that I've been doing that I showed you, I think, last week, with just putting the bar on your thighs and trying to balance it like that, those have been helping me so much just to get that full range. And I feel like now that I have more of a range, I have that much more strength as well, so it's really exciting. But hopefully it doesn't get too much colder, because when it gets cold, it's really hard to warm up and get started. And then workouts just take too long. Sorry, I was bouncing the camera because I'm doing this with my legs, because it's so cold. See you guys.